Jake something, you've been world champion for 450 days. Tonight I'm going to make this really short and sweet and simple for you. Two out of three falls, you're walking in champion. But I'm walking out that way.
Introducing first, representing the Dirty, from Detroit, Michigan, he is the War Wrestling Champion, Jake Something.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the main event here at War Wrestling's Dirty Intentions. I am Jimmy McDowell, joined ringside by our current commissioner, Mr. Dementia.
Hall of Famer.
That's right, Hall of Famer, Mr. Dementia, that's right.
That doesn't carry a lot of weight at home, so I gotta do that here.
And what a main event we have. It's for the
championship. That's disrespectful over the title right there.
Tossing the title like that, you mean?
Yeah, you gotta show real respect to that if you're the champ. But not surprising out of a member of the Dirty.
Now let's go back to ring announcer, another Hall of Famer, Slick Rick Toms.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing
absolutely,
the
absolutely. Well
from
done.
Columbus, Ohio, the Rock Star,
they don't just hand those out, you know. I've been in the ring with Jake Something. I've never been in the ring with Matt Taylor, but I don't think I want to.
I do say so myself, this is going to be one heck of a main event.
I think if the American Dream would say, it's going to be a slobber knocker.
I agree with that, slobber knocker for sure. The War Wrestling Champion, Jake Something from the Dirty, with a suddenly reappearing Ripper Blackheart.
I think he had a stomach ailment. I think something scared the crap out of him.
I agree with that. He'll be defending, Jake Something that is, will be defending against Dark Star Matt Taylor. Matt Taylor, of course, a former champion here in World Wrestling himself.
The first ever Respect champion, I believe, wasn't he?
Sounds right.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to announce at this time a World Wrestling champion, Jake Something, has been the War Wrestling Champion for 457 days!
If I'm doing my math right, that's at least a year, right?
I believe that is about a year and a half.
Yeah. At least one trip around the sun.
That sounds impressive until you think of the fact that myself and Stamp Lickage have technically been the World Wrestling Champions for 12 years.
This is two out of three falls.
Referee Joe, scratch that,
Jay Cortez.
Referee Jay Cortez calls for the bell, and this match is underway. This is a two out of three falls contest for the World Wrestling Championship.
Well, I'll tell you what, this is exciting matchups we have tonight. Taylor getting on top early with his speed.
I was just going to say, I think he would have to rely on his speed.
Well, he's not going to outpower Jake Something, because that kid's put together.
Taylor takes Something face first into that top turnbuckle. Now some knees to the midsection.
That's impressive right there, Jim.
Big old body slam right there.
Yeah, that's a lot smaller man picking him up. That's where you put your training in.
Running knee drop, going for a quick pin. Something able to kick out before the ref can even get down there.
Unfortunately here, Matt Taylor will be facing two men, as it is every time Ripper Blackheart is at ringside. Jake something a little slower and more methodical than Matt Taylor.
That's a very good observation.
It was kind of a shot in the dark.
Taylor, though, mounting a quick comeback here. Running kick. Rock something. Sue presses him down. Might have been a brain buster. Going for the pin. One, two, three, no.
Close to a pinfall there for this first one.
That's right. And again, this is the best two out of three falls. Something wants to keep the title. Dark Star would like to win it.
Thank you.
There's a...
I was trying to advance.
There's a chop by... Ooh, making two of them now. He's mixing chops and punches. Look at this offensive fury here.
There he goes to the first fist. They had some forearms in there. One thing Matt Taylor's doing, he's definitely staying on top of Jake Something.
Yeah, he is. Something now cowering down to the mat. I would think the Dark Star doesn't want to take it easy, though.
No, there's what happens. There's no doubt he'll be able to overpower pretty much any time he wants.
Something laying in those fists.
Yeah, he's now choking him, Jimmy.
Yep, choking him blatantly. Let's go right before the five count. Taylor puts on the brakes, reverses.
Nope, stays on the speed. Big forearm.
Taylor using his speed, going up top. Leaps, flying crossbody. Not able to go for the pin, though. We'll have to see later
on. I don't believe he chose to go for the pin.
Yeah.
He's setting up another offensive move.
Or trying to, at least. There's a chair in the ring. The referee grabbing the chair.
That's why he couldn't go for the move.
The referee does get rid of the chair. Is lecturing Ripper Blackheart.
Meanwhile, he's missing the chokehold on the other side of the ring by Blake Something.
Though it's a two out of three falls, this is not a no DQ match, which is why the referee is now arguing with Ripper Blackheart. Say that three times fast. A chair shot.
I don't want to do anything with Ripper Blackheart three times.
A chair shot to the side of the head by Jake Something rocks the skull.
Something is smart enough to know he's got to get back in the ring to get a pinfall.
Yeah. And after that chair shot, Matt Taylor might be out. Something, though, not going for a pinfall. You'd think Taylor would be easy pickings at this point.
Well, honestly, Jimmy, I'm not sure how much is going on up there.
Something now starting to pick a dazed Matt Taylor up. Taylor unable to even try and put up any offense here. Off the ropes. Great move by Something. One, two, three. That's the first fall.
He is impressive. He's right back on Taylor.
Hammering away on the side of Taylor's head, not letting him take a break, not letting him collect his senses. The referee pulling Something off. There is supposed to be a break in between the falls.
Well, the ref's at least got to be able to check the other competitor for injury.
Yeah.
Make sure he can continue.
Something is being relentless here, not wanting Taylor to try and collect his senses, to collect his thoughts.
Well, at least so far, Ripper hasn't physically gotten involved in this match.
So far, that's true. Give it time.
Well, he slid the chair, and it definitely was a distraction that led to the victory in the first fall.
Now that Taylor is back up to his feet.
What a shot.
Wow, geez, yeah.
He just
destroyed him. Yeah, as soon as Taylor gets to his feet, he's knocked back down.
Now he spoke too soon.
Yep.
There he is, choking him with a towel. If I weren't retired.
Something, a big elbow down on top of Darkstar here, making two of them. And those elbows are finding their mark.
Probably wouldn't be very commissioner-like to go up there and just slap the taste out of Ripper's mouth, would it?
It might not be the most professional, but I think it would be pretty fun.
It would be. I mean, I've done it before. Yeah. It is fun.
I'd like to see it.
I've slapped and tased. I've dropped elbows on him.
Yeah.
He's like a cockroach. He keeps coming back.
Meanwhile, Matt Taylor trying to fight out of this chin lock. And again, as soon as he's up to his feet, gets slugged back down. Something now picks Taylor up with ease. Oh, big backbreaker. Across the knee, going for the pin. One, two. Taylor is able to kick out right before three, though.
Just showed his fortitude there.
Yeah, he did.
And there's Ripper again.
Ripper choking Taylor while the referee has his back turned. If I were Taylor, I'd try and stay away from those ropes.
I don't know how you sit here beside Ripper every show.
Well, tonight I'm filling in for Michael McCormick. Normally I'm not. Although you bring up a good point, I'm not sure how he's able to sit beside Ripper for every show either. A stomp.
Well, they both smell similar.
A stomp by something else choking Matt Taylor as he bends Taylor's throat, his Adam's apple, right across that bottom ring rope. And of course, ring ropes, ladies and gentlemen, they're not real rope, they're actually steel cables.
Absolutely, they're airplane cables.
Yeah.
Taylor's just throwing fists now.
Yeah. He is so dazed.
Choke across the bottom rope is not legal, but it is effective.
Yeah, and he probably still hasn't collected a sauce from that chair shot, too. Barely kicks out right there, kicks out on instinct. But now going back to what I was saying, Taylor is so dazed right now. He's probably seeing stars. Those punches he was trying to throw.
Dark stars?
Ooh, I like it. That was good. They probably would be dark stars. Those punches he was trying to throw earlier on, catching nothing but air.
They were as close to hitting Jay Cortez as they were Jake Something.
Yeah.
Jake Something is relentless.
Yes, he is. He's definitely not a joke, that's for sure.
No, there's a reason he's been champ for 450-odd days.
That's right. Jake Something, I guess, trying to ugly up Matt Taylor with some fish hooks, stretching away at the face, clawing at the face.
Closed fist there. Oh, he's getting by the hair now.
I've always thought that's one downside of having long hair. It becomes an easy target.
Absolutely, absolutely. Only performed with long hair one time in my career. And it did become my downfall.
Chest first across the apron. And I guarantee you, on the edge of the ring.
Well, anything he's doing to the midsection, he's taking wind away.
Yep. And there's not a lot of padding on the edge of that ring either.
And he is not letting Matt Taylor catch his breath whatsoever.
Now, these are legal elbows.
They are. Legal forearms to the chest.
Yeah.
One of the few things he's done legal this entire match.
Yeah. Harden.
Oh, Taylor explodes.
From out of nowhere, that's right. Not sure where Taylor's getting this from, but. Taylor now with the head of steam. Something catches Taylor's leg, shrugs him off, but Something runs face first into Taylor's foot. Taylor double stomp off the top. This could be his chance. Hooks the leg. One, two, three. There it is.
Hey, Taylor gets the second fall. If I was Matt Taylor, I'd get right back on him the same way he did. Don't let him breathe here.
We'll have to see whether or not Taylor does that or whether or not he actually...
I don't think he's quite recovered yet.
No.
Taylor needs to at least distance himself here.
Well, the referee has called for the bell. Neither guy is on their feet.
We're going to start this third fall with a 10 count.
Yeah, they are. Now, of course, anytime you're a champion, you can win by count out and retain the title. You don't have to beat your opponent. Your opponent has to beat you.
Absolutely. The way you lose that belt is pinfall or submission. Taylor's to his feet. He doesn't look happy.
No, he doesn't. I think he's starting to get that adrenaline. Something, though, also up to his feet. And I think we're going to be starting over from scratch here, basically. This is all for the marbles, ladies and gentlemen. This is the third and final fall for the War Championship. Something trying to retain. Darkstar trying to win.
They are literally hitting each other right in the mouth.
That's right. It's not pretty, but it's effective, yeah.
Less, this is my kind of match.
Left and right from Dark Star. Something shoots him off the ropes. Dark Star gets out of that. Throws something to the outside. Here comes Dark Star. Dark Star, a suicide dive through the ropes.
He's got the champion reeling.
That's right. Knocks something to the floor.
Taking too much time here.
Ripper Blackheart looks a bit concerned now. I see those shades coming up.
Do you remember when I used to dive through the ropes like that?
No.
Me neither.
You weren't that suicidal as well.
No, I always liked myself a lot.
Yeah. Matt Taylor, definitely a risk taker, and I think that's why the fans love him so much. Wow, a big kick right there from Taylor. Catches something hard.
Risk taking is, you win a lot of matches, but it can hurt you too.
Yeah, that's right.
He's definitely passionate about his matches and his moves.
Well, kind of like gambling in Vegas, high risk, high reward.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, here we go again.
That's right. The fans, at least on the far side of the building, getting up to their feet as this action has spilled to the outside. The referee trying to get them to get back into the ring.
There is Jay Cortez out trying to get some order here.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what he can do when these guys get going.
I'm sure he does not want this match to end in a count out, so the referee trying to be lenient here. He's not administering the 10 count. And so he's just kind of letting these guys go. And go they are, going all over the building here.
I am not sure he's letting them do anything. They're close to the ring again, Jimmy.
Yeah, they are.
Oh, there was just a big kick right to the chest.
Jake, something not doing well as Matt Taylor, definitely in control right now.
Yeah, you would think on the outside would be something's advantage, but Matt Taylor's holding his own. Something's back in the ring, Jay Cortez, and here comes Taylor.
Well, Taylor's up on the edge of the ring. I don't know if he's ready to get back in the ring yet. Yeah, he does finally. Oh, wow, did you see that from Something? Something caught him. Going for the pin. Two, three, no.
I believe that, no. I believe that was the same maneuver he ended the first fall with.
It was.
Version of the black hole slam.
Yeah. It won the first time. It was not able to win this time, though. Probably because Taylor not as dazed this time as he was earlier on. Not as winded this time.
No. He'd been on top there for several minutes.
That's right.
Well, hey, we got a wrestling match again.
We did. Oh, wow.
That was a shot.
That rocked his jaw. Going for a powerbomb, but no.
Backslide.
He flips out. Backslide. This could be at one, two, something. Rolls out.
Before the three. Oh, super kick to the chest.
That's right. This could be Taylor's opening. One, two, three, no.
Oh, Ripper grabs the referee's leg. Ripper pulls Jay Cortez right out of the ring.
Cortez needs to throw Ripper out of here.
Matt Taylor has a submission in the ring.
Ripper, Taylor rather, trying to win this match. Something gets his foot over to the rope. He's going to have to break the hold. Matt Taylor had this match.
I believe
match
if the ref would have been in the ring, he would have won.
I think so. Taylor
think
was
Taylor
robbed right there. Taylor was robbed, that's for sure.
The judges show that Jake Something is a fighting champ. He didn't tap out there.
Taylor now showing his strength. He picks Something up onto his shoulders. Something is able to get off.
Big boot to the side of the face.
Yeah.
Oh! Give up. Taylor is just relentless.
He doesn't ever give up, that's for sure.
No, big forearm. Just trading shots.
Yeah, they are. Back and forth, this match goes. Rear waist lock now. Jake Something stops.
Oh, he slams Taylor right into Jay Cortez.
But actually, Taylor was going for an avalanche splash. Something moved out of the way. Taylor
posted him.
Taylor caught the referee with the avalanche splash. The referee is down. something with a chair. Oh, wow.
Why does he have to go this way?
Something just used the top of the chair, the brim of the chair, right on the side of the head of Matt Taylor.
Well, for once, now they bring out Kopath to make the count. Oh, he kicks out! Matt Taylor kicked out.
Amazingly, I'm surprised he's still conscious.
Another shot to the side of the head with that chair. Let me tell you, these UAW Hall chairs are about 90 years old.
And they
I think
hard.
They made them in the factory with the trains they used to make here in Lima.
Yeah.
They are massive.
But wait, Taylor rolls him over. Super kicks him right in the face. Going for the pin. This for the championship, too.
Another kick out by something. We're on our third fall and our second ref.
Yeah.
This is amazing. I believe there's going to be a firearm needed to finish this match.
It might reach that point.
Our second ref is down. Topaz has been knocked to the ground, too. Taylor rolls through for that submission again.
And I think we're out of referees. Where's Shauna Reed when you need her?
Cortez is...
Wait, yeah, here comes Cortez.
Slithering back into the ring at best.
Cortez calling for the bell here. We'll see what the official decision is. This could be interesting. This could go
I'm
either
sure
way.
What happened there. I couldn't see from our vantage point. That gave this match to Matt Taylor.
Darkstar Matt Taylor is awarded the War Championship. The official referee assigned to this match, Jay Cortez, is able to crawl his way back into the ring.
He just took the ref. He just took the belt back.
Well, no, Joe Kopath. Joe took the belt away.
No, Jay Cortez took the belt away. Joe Kopath is sitting in disbelief. I think Kopath called for the bell.
Well, both referees seem confused right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, the original referee in this match has disqualified Jake something. That means the winner of the first.
That means he retains his title,
disqualification.
Jimmy.
Disqualification is Darkstar Matt Taylor. However, the only way
title doesn't change hands on a disqualification
is by pinfall or submission. Still, War Wrestling Champion.
That's a shame. That's a shame.
By virtue of a technicality, Matt Taylor is getting screwed.
Jake Something's got no reason to be gloating. He just took a butt whooping.
The crowd wants more. They're chanting one more fall.
We don't have any refs left.
But yeah, no, we're out of referees. Well, Matt Taylor kicks something, kicks him again. Yeah.
Something's out of the ring. He's not coming back in.
Something rolls to the outside. I don't know.
I know Ripper well enough, though. He's going to scoop his guy up and get him out of here.
I don't know if something rolled to the outside. I don't know if Jake rolled to the outside intentionally or involuntarily from those two kicks.
A little bit of both. I think momentum was taking him, and he just went. Yeah.
Well, Jake Something wants no part of the fourth fall.
He saw that a little differently than most of the people here did.
Yeah. Can't say I'm surprised.
Well, so, I'll tell you what, Jimmy, in my time away, I sure have missed the action here. Wow, I was only here for four matches, and it was exciting.
So, Darkstar Matt Taylor wins 2 out of 3 falls, but because he won the third fall by DQ, Jake Something is able to retain his title. Ladies and gentlemen, for Ripper Blackheart and for Mr. Dementia, Commissioner Dementia, I'm Jimmy McDowell saying thank you for watching War Wrestling's Dirty Intentions here from the UAW Hall in Lima, Ohio. We hope to see you on January 7th for our next event, Lights Out.